Okay, so hey guys. How the hell did I change clothes?
So, this video took a long time to make, so I don't have an entire script. So I'm just gonna deal it with the few notes that I had written down and a few videos I made that I posted on my Instagram stories right after I watched a couple of episodes. And yeah, so I'm gonna throw those in. And yeah, so I hope that this video will turn into something that I can even post. This is the second time trying to record this video. It's just a real mess, so yeah. Thank you guys for even trying to watch this video. But anyways, let's start. I have the green screen up, but this is not going to work at all. Anyway, let's start how the season started, with the first two episodes and a 2-hour premiere. We started 8 months after the first season ended, and it's very interesting to see the contrast between Tyrone hiding out at the church instead of Tandy at the start of the first season. Something that happened at the beginning of episode 2, I think, was when the guy at the club, he used the cocaine to create this VV on the floor, and I think it was for Papa Legba, the one who stands at the crossroads. We see him later in the season, but we'll get to that. But we, in the same episode, you can see Auntie Chantel using flour to well, not create a VV, but just for baking. So there's also some imagery with Tyrone and Tandy both spying on people, and it's really interesting to see something Cloak and Dagger does a lot. Is when Tyrone is having a conversation with someone and Tandy is having a conversation with someone, you get like the first sentence in one conversation and then it cuts back to another, to the other conversation. And it's something that Cloak and Dagger does a lot, and it's I don't know, I find it really cool. But after a while you start to notice it more and more, so yeah. It happens a lot. Oh, one of the most powerful scenes in the whole season was with Tandy practicing her ballet with her daggers, and it shows a lot of flashbacks and flashing lights, and it's a real powerful scene. So yeah, I really like that scene. Episode 2 follows 3 perspectives from episode's 1 final scene. That was also really cool to see. It had a lot of time jumps, and sometimes it was a bit hard to follow, but I could manage. But yeah, so episode 1 ended with the fight in the club. Episode 2 starts out with Tyrone heading to Avida's place to speak with Auntie Chantel about the VV. Yeah, that's really interesting. It's really interesting about in the whole season about how they changed the like dark dimension to have more to do with the Loa. And it then comes back to the finale from episode 1. But then instead follows Tandy from then forth. And I thought the time jumps were really cool. When Tandy and Bridget meet again, they show you Bridget's, O'Reilly's stance on the whole thing, and her calling the police, pretending to be someone else. And you get to see Mayhem's origins in a reflection of puddle. At first I thought it was a cliche, and that it was just in O'Reilly's mind, like the split personalities and stuff, but later we figured out that Mayhem was a separate person, which I thought was a really cool take. I really didn't expect it. There was also a part of the episode where they went to Tandy and Andre the Shane went to the neighborhood and looked at the people looking at the missing person posters, and I thought that scene was handled really well. It's talked about racism in the media and was handled subtly and really well.
That's more than a dozen girls. Where are the cops? The reporters, they should be all over this.
They would be if you went missing. Pretty blonde girl with a beautiful white mother to cry all over the TV. Breaking news and updates every few hours. But here, where the people in trouble are poor brown girls.
That's awful.
That's the world, Tandy.
Tandy's light force powers were so well built up, and they looked really awesome. I even used it in my All This Power MCU video, and we're gonna talk about All This Power again in a few episodes. Let's see, Mayhem is really intimidating, and I had a line here, Mayhem is a separate person. So yeah, I was really shocked by that. So that was a really, really cool reveal. Now we have episode 3, which I actually talked about on my Instagram stories. Go follow me on Instagram. Behind me. Okay, so I just watched Cloak and Dagger season 2, episode 3. I'm gonna make the video tomorrow, hopefully. I'll get it done by Sunday or something. But man, this season 2 is already so much better than season 1. And this episode was great, and I really like what they are doing.
I want my hair back.
Tandy is still all over the place. But yeah, really great show. That's a thing that happened a lot in this season. Tandy is all over the place, like I said. Tandy is a really inconsistent character. With that happened in season 1, like episode 9, with her feeding off of people's hopes and stuff. That wasn't the person they were building up to. They kind of fixed it in episode 10. But yeah, her whole stance about like killing people and about the missing girls and bringing them back and all that crap. I thought Tandy went way overboard with that, and it was just that the writers weren't building up to it. They were just like, oh, Tandy thinks like this. I don't know. But I just thought that Tandy has always been a little inconsistent. But yeah, let's see. That was all I had to say about episode 3, I guess. Although I think that's the episode where they saved the girls in the warehouse. I thought the VFX looked really awesome. Cloak is still one of my favorite superheroes. So yeah, that's why I recreated that effect at the beginning of the video. But yeah, let's see episode 4. I also posted this on my Instagram stories. Okay, Cloak and Dagger season 2 episode 4. What an episode. Probably my favorite of the whole series. Tyrone not being able to do his thing, intentionally vague, was a bit of a lazy moment, but in the end you realize why. Great episode, great show. So this is the episode I've been waiting for a whole since Cloak and Dagger started. Dagger went into Cloak's lower dimension, I guess, as they call it now, and she meets Papa Legba. She went in there to get Mayhem, but unintentionally got Connors out instead of Mayhem, and you know, it set up a lot of things and was really cool. How they handled it, I'm still not 100% sure how the lower dimension works exactly, But I thought they handled it really well, and it's obviously a main staple of Cloak and Dagger, having Dagger going to Cloak's cloak. Although it was really weird how, now that I think about it, his thing was that Tyrone couldn't teleport anymore. It was because Tandy gave up her powers going into the lower dimension, but a few episodes later we learned that you could just give Puppet Leg a Snickers bar and it's all okay. I still think that's really weird, but I guess it's the voodoo stuff. I don't know, but it was interesting. Let's see, episode 5. I wrote down some things later. All the spiral scene is awesome.
I wanna find that bastard that killed my brother. The brightest star is born. No one's ever seen a light that shines as bright as this. Like the cosmos might explode. Everything ceases to exist.
Obviously I really liked that scene since I used it for my MCU edit. I hate that I didn't use the cello part in my video, and they did use it obviously for Cloak and Dagger. I just forgot about it. I trimmed the song down because I didn't have any more clips, but I should have used that. The fake out with Connors is great and unexpected. I thought it was really great that Connors didn't just return to go back to his role of being a dickhead and trying to kill Tyrone. He actually wanted to pay for his crimes, and I thought it was really interesting how being in this solitary confinement, being in this lower dimension of Cloak, that it had taught him how, it taught him a lesson about what he did, and that he should be brought to justice. The Viper Farmer story sections with Tandy are, they were really weird, and I couldn't follow it for a lot of it, but they become clear at the end why everything is happening, why the red and blue lights are going off, and where we even are in those sections. JD Evermore shines as Connors. I really like the actor. I like his portrayal of Connors, and as a man who has been in solitary confinement for 8 months apparently, so that was really cool. Andre Duchesne, Despair, was a twist villain, but a really unexpected one, and I still stand by that. I really think that, I really liked Despair, the whole twist, and the direction that season 2 took. I wasn't really interested in Mayhem after the first 2 episodes. She was just she's an edgy O'Reilly, but she has really sharp nails or something. It was interesting. And it was pretty menacing after that, so. Andre. The breakup was a bit too fast and heavy-handed, but it's not really a main focus. With that, I'm talking about the scene where Tandy uses Tyrone as to get information out of Leah, and it was really weird how Tyrone was just I'm over it, the divine pairing shit, who cares. So all that stuff about the divine pairing and stuff, he just totally forgot about that and was just like, oh, you used me? Well, fuck you then. And he went off. Again, not building up to anything. This show really needs... Every season has 10 episodes, but with shows like The Flash or Arrow or like DC TV shows, they always have like 23 episodes or something. And I think a lot of that is filler. But I think a show like Cloak and Dagger could really use a couple of more episodes to really build to these revelations. The Tyrone infiltration sequences were pretty awesome, like him stealing the key from the Monopoly Man. The Monopoly file isn't brought up again, and so that's pretty take it or leave it. It leads to a pretty cool scene with him threatening Connors. The nightmare scene with Lady Justice turning a blind eye, get it? To the acts of Connors is interesting, and him putting on the handcuffs and them just breaking, falling down. I thought that was really interesting. And so that puts an end to episode 5. Let's see, episode 6. Okay, so this one I posted about on my Instagram again. Cloak and Dagger season 2, episode 6. What a fucking ride, man. So mind-boggling, and just when you think everything's as it should be, they pull the rug right off of your feet, right from under your feet. Absolutely phenomenal. The review will come once the season is done, episode 10. Sure. Or like 2 months after that. So mind-boggling, yeah. Oh yeah, this was the episode where you had Tandy in all these different mindscapes, and with Tandy being in this like dream world where everything's perfect, but every time she thinks all hope is lost, Tyrone is there so that they can become the divine pairing again. And every time that happens, a new dream world is like created, and every time it gets worse and worse for Tandy, just so that Andre can feed off of her or something. And just when you think that she is in reality again, they pull the trigger on Tyrone, and you immediately notice like, oh, they're still in a dream world. And they broke Tandy in that episode, and it was really cool. Episode 7, I don't have anything on that. The Viking Hotel or something. It was really cool. The ending scene with Tandy throwing multiple daggers at once, and Tyrone having some really cool sequences was really cool. Cloak and Dagger season 2, episode 8. Weird episode. I just don't understand half of it anymore, but I like it. I hope everything gets explained before the season ends. It doesn't. Still, I love the show. Yeah. Episode 8 was really... It was really weird. Aveda marrying Baron Samedi. Which I really liked Baron Samedi in that episode. And you had Chantel returning from the dead, Black Panther style, and like the whole video game aspect of it, it was weird. But and like I said there, I hoped everything got explained before the season ended. It didn't. Why was the lower dimension? Why did he have access to the record store, like Andre the Shane's record store, and how does that work if Tandy is in the lower dimension with Andre Duchesne? What? I don't know. I just didn't understand the connection between the record store from Andre Duchesne's mindscape and Tyrone's access to it. But yeah, I know I post these things at the weirdest times, but hear me out. Cloak and Dagger episode 209. A couple of the same problems I had with episode 109. Some character writing felt changed out of the blue. This episode did handle it better though. The trailer for episode 10 looks amazing, can't wait. That is true, I can't really remember why though. Something I didn't mention about the last episode was that Tyrone's motherfucking killed Connors, and I still really don't like that. It was not handled well, they didn't really return to it, except for episode 9 where Tyrone learns it happened, but not directly from her, because she lies about it. Don't know why, how, like, she can't hide that forever. Her whole thing was bring him to justice, and now she just fucking killed him, and they didn't even talk about it that much. But yeah, so I really did not like why. I really did not like that happened. I wanted him to just get put in jail like he wanted, and yeah, have that whole storyline come to an end. But no, she just had to kid him. Okay, well, I really hated that. Let's keep talking about episode 9. Yeah, episode 9 was really cool, seeing Andre's backstory, seeing Leah's backstory kind of with her concert, and so those parts were really cool. And the ending was pretty interesting. It was really interesting how they kind of took him down, but it was too late. And then we go on to the last episode, episode 10. And I also posted something on Instagram, obviously. Ugh, do I love it or do I hate it? There are cool moments, but the pacing's horrible, it is. The powers are cool, but some are just goofy, the dagger sword. And the emotional moments are good but forced. Review coming up. Kind of. I really didn't like the season 2 finale, but also I kind of did. It should have been longer. It should have been multiple episodes. But obviously they had time constraints and just made it. And Cloak finally wears a cloak again. Which is just in the dream world, so, or in like the lower dimension, so it doesn't even matter anymore. And yeah, the rest of it, there are cool moments, like Tyrone fighting Tyrone, and Tandy coming to grips with her father, which was a bit forced, but they did kind of build it up over the season, so that's a kind of cool moment. I thought the sword looked goofy, but the like emotional implications of it were really cool. And yeah, that's it. I don't have much to say about the finale, which kind of sucks. And there is a crossover episode coming from Marvel's Runaways. I haven't watched that show. I really should. And yeah, and then we'll see how that crossover episode will fit in with the Cloak and Dagger lore. I really don't like this video. I know I say that a lot in my videos, but this video, I hope I can save it in the edit. The green screen is not gonna work. And my English is really off this video, but I'm not gonna redo it because I have put this video off for way too long. I need to post something. I really want to post something again. I do think that my next video will be really cool. I hope that it will. It's gonna be in the style of early Bionic Pig videos or Drew Gooden / Danny Gonzalez. So yeah, I really hope that that video turns out cool. But yeah, thank you anyway for watching this video, and yeah, overall, I still really like Cloak and Dagger. I hope they get a third season, and I hope they do something great with the third season and take things a little bit more easy and not so complicated. I really like Joe Pokowski. He clearly really loves what he's doing, and he really loves the characters. Follow him on Instagram or something, like I do. And yeah, he really sees this as his passion project, and I really enjoy having, like, seeing a creator having so much fun with its characters and seeing that he really cares for them and really cares for its show is really cool. I really respect that. I hope he takes it a bit more lightly the next season, and a bit less complex, and I think that would really do a lot for the show. But overall, I still really love the characters, I really love the show, and that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and bye. So if you stuck around this long, thank you guys. And I'll tell you about there's a little reward. I'll tell you about the topic for the next video, which is AI Angel, the creation of Rogue Shadow and Unity and its imagination. I'll talk about ethics and philosophy, and but I'll take it a bit more lightly in the style of Danny Gonzalez, Drew Gooden, those kinds of people here. Take that as you will. Bye.